Hi, my name is Muhammad Nazrul Mubin. I'm from class BA1183B. My ID number is 2019-866056. Today I would like to give a speech about a game they call PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds, PUBG. PUBG Mobile is a game that has spread worldwide and it was exciting based on the comment and feedback from the players. I'm here to talk about the strategies to reach the highest tier in PUBG. It is based on my own experience and from the other pro players that played in the tournament. PUBG has spread all over the globe and over 100 million players have downloaded the game. I'm sure that the people that have downloaded this game have an experience of fun moment with their friend while playing this game. I'm happy to share with you guys on the strategies how to reach the highest tier in PUBG. There are three strategies to reach the highest tier in PUBG, which is Conqueror. Firstly, you need to plan your strategies to get into the play zone. Second, you need to focus on your surround to keep you safe from the other enemies. And lastly, controlling your weapon recoil to make sure your enemies are knocked out when you shoot them. Among the strategies to reach the highest tier in PUBG, people use various types of strategy to get into the play zone. First, you need a rotation. You need to know how to make a rotation, and at the same time, you need aware of the existence of the enemy. Otherwise, if you fail to do your rotation, the enemy will know your location and they will open a fire on you. As you can see, these are the rotation that have been made by Yudugang and the other team to get into the play zone. Second, Scouter. This is the most important role in PUBG. The person that have been given the role, you need to be a brave one because you need to lead your whole team into the new compound in the play zone. Other than that, Scouter needs to check on the whole compound before they can move into a new compound. If not, you will face the enemy and will fight with them. I would like to show you the gameplay of a scouter in this video.
Pemasap telah pun dilemparkan. Jumper, tembakan demi tembakan dilepaskan. Di dalam situasi ini, dua orang pemain yang berlepaskan blok Gimi. Tembakan yang terkena satu knockdown. Percaya itu langsung daripada Jumper sekarang ini. Luar yang terbaik untuk pasukan Diudo. Masuk ke dalam belantan ataupun terus. Mereka barbar. Mereka mahukan kerataan dan seperti mari kita dapat saksi.
Furthermore, we need to focus on our surrounding to keep ourselves safe while in the play zone. Awareness. Keep checking on your surrounding if the enemy are close to you or in the other compound around you. If all of your teammates did not put their awareness on their surrounding, your position is in the dangerous. Furthermore, information is the most useful thing in the game. As a team, you need to give your teammate information on the enemy position if the enemy are nearby or in the other compounds. Moreover, this is an advantage for your whole team to make a decision either to take a fight or being a third party in the fight. Lastly, you must know how to control your weapon recoil when you shoot at the enemy. Skills. The skills that you need to control your recoil is you need the experience on using the gyroscope, because it helps you a lot on controlling your weapon recoil to make sure the enemy are knocked out. Other than that, sensitivity. As a pro player, you need to search for your own sensitivity that suits to your phone. The sensitivity is important to player to keep the recoil in a good firing path. When you have a good firing path, it will help you knock the enemy instantly. In conclusion, strategies are the key to reach the highest tier because it helps you to get into the play zone, focus on your surround, and to control your weapon recoil. I hope that what I delivered today will fulfill the thing that you need to play the games. Thank you.